Hey, horse people. I think Buddy caught the scent of this. I put out alfalfa hay, and he wasn't paying attention. Then all of a sudden, they both started coming his way. I wish I'd have got their initial. You see him working the wind? The wind is blowing kind of this direction. So Buddy's working it. The alfalfa is way up here. But that's exactly where the scent cone would be. Now maybe because I got out of my car. See, he's working his head. Maybe because I got out of my car, he's going to think he's going to come to me. But I think he's going to work the alfalfa smell. Mr. T smelling it too. See, Mr. T is turning. See, they're both turning into the wind. They're walking directly into the wind right now. And that's where the wind is blowing it. So he's kind of looking at me and he's like, I smell the alfalfa out here, Dad. And this is how they smell predators. I've done this before. So he's working that scent. But see, the scent's going to lead him to the fence. So he's got to go around the fence. Here comes Mokey. And he's going to come around that fence and he'll go right to the alfalfa. Dog, I wish I'd have got it when I couldn't get out of the car in time to get the camera on. And he's going to walk up right to the alfalfa. Should be in that area. Because that's exactly where this wind was blowing it. Boom, he's on it. What a good boy! He smelt his little alfalfa! So I'll go out here sometime and just set up and try to hide their food when they're way out there not paying attention. And then I'll let them use their nose and use their senses to work their way to it. That way they can find food. Now they can find it on their own and they do that naturally. But when I put out good alfalfa or different hay, I went out there probably 10 minutes ago, put that hay out and filled up their water bucket. And I was just going to head out. And I'm going down to Denton and I was like, shit, I think Buddy just caught that scent. And the wind is blowing exactly where it was going. I'm surprised Buddy hasn't spun around and put his butt to the wind. Because he usually doesn't like to eat with his wind. If we watch this for a second, I bet you in a minute, if the wind picks up a little bit, you'll see his butt swing to the right. And he'll move his butt to that wind. Because I think the dust blows in their nose. Mr. T usually doesn't care. See, Mr. T is downwind. So the dust and everything is blowing right in Mr. T's face. And Buddy's kind of at an angle. But normally, Buddy likes to spin his butt. And get that butt to the wind. They're like, cool. There's free hay out here. We're just out here wandering around. And again, I'll do that sometimes at night. I'll spread it out in a different pasture. So while they're roaming in the middle of the night. Remember, they only sleep 2 hours a day. And those 2 hours are 10 minutes here, 15 minutes here, etc. So they're always out there grazing and roaming, which is why it's so bad to lock them up. I've said it 1,000 times. You know, it's just boredom to death. And you got to wait for somebody to come feed them. And then they gorge down their food. And not good for them. So hiding their food in different little piles when they're not paying attention. And then they get to find it. What the hell's that noise? Is that Mokey jumping on this truck? What's that crazy cat doing? I thought I heard his butt. What are you doing, boy? I thought somebody's trying to break into the truck. About to pull out a gun and shoot you. What's wrong with you, crazy old cat? What's wrong with you, you crazy old cat? You got a little sparkle right there on your head. Dad tried to get it off and he missed it. Come here. Come here, all over here. You get over here, you're going to be a bad cat. So anyway, for those people that are watching for the dog left. I haven't seen him come back, but after the dog left, I didn't see any of the rabbits all night. I went to a party Saturday night and I got back at midnight and I didn't see any of the rabbits, so I'm kind of like, And then all day Sunday, I didn't see them. And I was like, oh, no, they're gone. Because they're always here in the morning for their food. Or they're always hanging around in that barn during the day at some time. And I didn't see them all day. And I said, damn, those dogs must have killed them all. I was feeling bad. I was going to post a video. And I was just kind of like feeling kind of yucky all day. Because it just, I felt so bad for them. And you kind of, I kind of like looking out in the morning and seeing them and eating them. Throwing them a little food. So I was feeling pretty bad if those dogs ate them, but I get it. I mean, it is what it is. And then at like 11 o'clock at night, I came out to drop the horses some hay and they were here. And I was like, are you kidding me? where the hell have you guys been? And I noticed Mama's left eye is gone. It's either poked out or bashed, or somebody grabbed her in the head and she escaped. So I don't know if it was the dogs, if it was a wolf, where they ran, where were they for almost 24 hours to a day and a half, because they were gone for quite a long time. And I thought I'd lost all three of them. And you know what? They all three showed back up. They looked a little worse for the wear. Mama was moving slow, licking her hind quarter, like maybe she had an injury. Gave them some food, gave them a little banana and grapes, and been feeding them the last few days, and they're back to their normal routine, hanging around here every day. So I don't know if the dog spooked them, chased them, if there was a coyote, if there's some other predator that came in or what, but I thought I lost all three, but they're all three back. I was like, yay! My little friends are back. So anyway, the rabbits are okay, other than Mama missing her left eye now. It's not bad enough that she's got to make it out here with all these predators. Now she's only got one eye. But at least she's got her two little friends that kind of, you know, hang with her and keep an eye in early, you know, somebody be calling the rabbits buddy sour now. They only want to hang out with their other rabbits. They don't love me. Whatever. Freaking crazy people in the horse world. Anyway, I just saw these guys working this because they were way out there by Mr. Rooster. And they caught that scent because the wind is just, it's not so strong that the scent cone was really bad. Now, I've done quite a few videos on scent cones and stuff. Usually when I throw my ashes from my fireplace out, you can watch it blow in the wind, and that's exactly what blows all the time for humans or predators or anything. So anyway, they're having a little snack. There's actually, don't tell them, there's actually another pile to their right, but because they hit that one, they didn't realize another scent. So later they won't see it. It's in the tall grass. When they go back out here, they're gonna smell it and come back and go, wait a minute, there must be more, unless Buddy sees it. Sometimes his eyes are better and he'll see it. And then there's also some non-alfalfa hay up by the water bucket. So anyway, all right, we'll go ahead and net there on the horses using their nose to find food and hay and predators and all the other stuff that people think they can't do because they just need us to save them. All right, Buddy Mifty, you're good boys. And Mokey and the rabbits too. I got to add this in. This cat's killing me. This is where that skunk came by and sprayed on the ground. Look at this crazy cat. Acting like a maniac, rolling all where that skunk was. I'm gonna beat him like a redheaded stepchild. You crazy cat, look at you. You got dirt all over you rolling in that crazy skunk smell. There ain't no sense in that. And that was like, shit, 4 days ago. But he must still smell something. He's like being all crazy. You crazy cat, you. I was checking for him before I started the truck to see where he went, and I came back here and he was rolling around that skunk smell. I'm like, you big no-knowing crazy cat. All right, I'm really in that there. Bye. Thought these guys were both they were both crashed out. Buddy woke up because I came up here. He was laying out like a dead dog. Mr. T's laying down. What a good boy. Hi. Hi, boys. What are you guys doing? Maybe Dad, I got a cookie in the truck. Maybe I got a cookie. All right, I'll add this into some video.